Alright guys, so today we're going to do another video. This video is going to be a little bit different, honestly. Today I'm going to show you a couple tricks that I use to put my hooks and split rings on my lures. And how to preserve these baits a little bit by doing so. These are some lures that I've already painted. I've just been waiting to put hooks on them. Actually all these lures I've done a previous video on, so today we're just going to be putting some hooks and lures, or some hooks and split rings on these lures. I'm just gonna kind of walk you guys through a method that I use to do it. So let's go ahead and we'll get our tools together. Typically I have these Rapala split ring pliers that I use. First thing I gotta do is take these eyelets. Some of them fill in with the clear coat. And I got the rubber bands, obviously, so I gotta take these off and I gotta clean up these eyelets a little bit. You guys can see them, they fill in with the clear coat. So let's go ahead and do that and then we'll get back to you afterwards. Okay, so I got these all cleaned up. I just take a razor blade, you know, typical. It's a cheap one off of Amazon that I can replace the blade with. And I just kind of cut out the eyelets if they're filled in a little bit. So, weren't too bad. Did down a couple of them. So, let's go ahead and we're gonna choose what hooks we're gonna put on these hooks and split rings. So go ahead and get in my hooks and split ring drawer here. So I keep all my hooks in that drawer and I have all my split rings in this little tackle container. So for my 13s I usually do 7-inch hook or 7-aught hooks. My 10-inch Jake's I'll do 5-aught hooks. And all my other ones, my believers, anything like that, I usually do a 6-aught hook. So I got all those out here. So I got all these out here. We're gonna go ahead and do these two first. All these hooks that I use are Mustad treble hooks. I get them all from Barlow's Tackle, same as my split rings. I really like them. It's hard to find hooks this big for muskie. To buy them in bulk, so I found that Barlow's is one of the best places to get them. I am an affiliate with Barlow's, so if you want to go down below, check them out. There's a link in the description. Use code DHBaits at checkout, and it'll really help support the channel. Just lets them know that I sent you. So let's go ahead and use these number 6-aught hooks. And these are bulk packages that I bought, but I just condensed them. So I have a few in here I have a couple in here. How many am I gonna need? 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Put those back in there. So for split rings for all these, on the 13-inch lures, I usually use a size 6 stainless steel split ring. Like I said, I get these from Barlow's as well in bulk. And then on these other ones, the 10-inch lures and 8-inch lures, I'll typically use a number 5 stainless steel split ring. It's just a tiny bit smaller. So let's go ahead and get some of those out of the package. And these aren't just, they have different kinds of split rings, obviously. I believe they're stainless steel, but they're a thicker version of the split rings. I can't remember exactly what they are, but they're the thicker version. They do have thinner ones as well. And that's what I use on all my musky gear, because I wanted the bigger split rings. So all I do to gear these up is I take and I actually put these split rings on the hooks first, on all the hooks before I put them on the baits. Found that that's easier. You know, you just kind of use your pliers to open the split rings, spin them around, and then your split rings on their hook. So let's go ahead and put that on for all these six-aught hooks, and we'll get that done. It is kind of tricky when you're first starting out to get these split rings on, because they're so big. Like I said, I have these Rapala pliers that I bought. I'm not sponsored by them or anything like that, but I found that these were the best. They have a real small tooth on them to get in between the split rings, and I found that works really good for these larger ones. But once you learn how to do it and get the hang of it, you know, it just comes second nature after that. So, all right, so we got those split rings on the hooks, and now what I'll do is I'll put all the hooks on the lures. So I take the hook with the split ring, just like I did to put it on the hook. Open it up, and you just kind of do the same exact thing. Get it started, and then you can work it all the way around your lure eye. And then you got your hook on, just like that. So let's go ahead and put the rest of these on. Okay, so I got those on there. Got the hooks on, these lures. So now I'm going to show you guys what I do as a trick. Basically, I tee my hooks. You spend so much time working on these lures. You want them to stay, you know, in pristine condition, basically. You want to keep them as long as you can. So a lot of times, if you don't tee your hooks, the hooks will wear right here on the bellies. And you'll get wear marks on your hooks from them rotating in the water. And it kind of scuffs up your clear coat and your paint jobs. So in order to prevent that, I'll take these hooks and I tee them, which is why I like these Mustad hooks, because they're really strong, but you're able to bend them and work with them a little bit. So I'll show you guys how I do that. I got a pair of pliers. It can be any kind of pair of pliers. This one's just a wire bending plier that you can see that I have laying around, needle nose. So take your hook, and you want to get so it's laying flat against the bait. So it'll go through the water perfectly. And so you're making sure you want to tee the right ends of the hooks. So I need to tee this end and this end, the one that are close to the bait. So I go ahead and take these, take the hook, flip it over, and grab one with the pliers and the other one with the other set of pliers. All right, so once you get your hook bent around like that, your hook is teed. Oops. Your hook is teed, and it'll no longer wear against the belly of the bait like it did before. You're just preventing these hooks from doing hook rash on your paint job. So let's go ahead and finish up putting the hooks on these other baits. It's the same process, the same way. Yeah, I guess that's it. That's what I wanted to show you guys, is a trick to keeping your baits from wearing out on the paint job so hard. And that's all I do to keep to put the hooks on and keep them from wearing against the bait. So let's go ahead and finish up these other baits, and then we'll get back to you once we're done. All right, so we got them all done. All the hooks are on. I did end up putting fives on this. Seems like it's gonna be a better fit. I'll bend all these hooks afterwards. But that's all I do to put these hooks on. You know, it seems like it's the most time efficient way for me to put hooks on. So that's how I do it. If you guys have any better suggestions, I'm always open to it. Make sure to leave a comment down below if you do. Maybe you guys have a better idea for putting them on quicker. But yeah, so as always, guys, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Feel free to comment down below if you guys have any other ideas, like always. And I'll see you guys in the next one.